Are we rolling?
Yep, yep, look up.
Okay. Hi.
So between the two of us, I talk less and Vibha talks too much. She just overcompensates.
Wow, I did not expect that. Okay. Yeah,
she calls me for 2 minutes and the call will go on for 20.
Insider information.
But yeah, so I always thought that since she talks so much, she would make a great radio jockey.
Okay, thanks, da. So sweet. Yeah, no, I mean, I've always been really inspired by their work, and I can't believe that you can make a career out of, you know, just talking, yeah, so just well. Talking. Yeah, it blows my mind.
Yeah. You know, as a kid, I used to think that behind the speaker of the radio, there were tiny people who sit and
what?
Talk.
Dude, what? Are you serious?
Yeah, I didn't know there was such a thing as an RJ and a studio and all that.
That's that funny. Okay, anyway, cool thing is, we actually got to go behind the scenes and meet Disha Oberoi, who's a really popular RJ in Bangalore, and we asked her so many questions and just learned so much from her.
Yeah, we had a great interview with her.
Yep.
You can also watch all the other interviews that we've done from across the country of people of different professions on our channel.
Yep.
Used to fly for an airline and we used to make announcements like we did back in the days. These days you have TV screens, so somebody said nice voice. I said, hey, why don't we make some money out of this? So I was on a sabbatical for 6 months and I googled which is the nearest radio station in my house, and I just walked in. I said, look, can I do ads and, you know, make some money? He said, why don't you be a radio jockey? One thing led to another and I landed a show in Chennai. No, I was not a morning person. I was a nocturnal being. I loved being a nocturnal creature. I used to do the evening show. So my schedule, I would sleep at 4 a.m., wake up for lunch, eat, go to work, and I loved it. And when I came here, I didn't have a choice. So I actually requested the management and I said, listen, can you please put me on the evening slot? And they said, why? Because morning's a good slot too. Why would you not want to do it? So I said, do you want me to lie or say the truth? And they said, no, of course, say the truth. And I said, I can't wake up. And they just told me to bugger off and I had to do it. I'm still doing it and I love it. I think being a morning person is way better. At 16, I was really scattered. I wanted to do too many things. I'd tell myself to just focus on sport and play sport seriously and see if I can pursue it and play for India at some stage. But that didn't happen. So I would tell myself to just be a little more. You gotta do it, yeah. There is no choice in the matter. You're a professional, you have to get up. And when you're doing it so often, you find hacks to distract yourself. You get into the zone, you listen to some songs that you really like. You know, but there's nothing specific. Once your body clock is set, you're active at that time. You realize that, you know, when you're waking up every day at the same time, your mind just opens up. You may be slightly cranky, grumpy, but you can deal with it. It's not overwhelming, so it's fine. So I got a death threat because the guy was pissed off with something I had apparently said a few weeks ago. There was one guy, he called from Whitefield saying there was a dead body. And it didn't occur to him to call the ambulance or police first. He picked up the phone and out of panic just said, you know, I don't know who to call. And he called me and that was another strange call. This man who named his daughter after me, I still find it very overwhelming. But that was, he called and said, we just had a baby girl and we've named her. Like, she had like two names and one part of the name was mine. And I was like, wow, okay. You know, actually, I remember there were floods in Andhra at one point and all connectivity had dropped. TV, telephone, internet. And the police, the people, got in touch and passed on very critical information through the medium of radio. I remember this happening, and this happened during the Chennai floods as well, where relief material was taken back and forth. A lot of communication was being carried through radio while everything else failed. So radio is a very powerful medium. And it's not just going to be a background medium in the future, it's going to be a very critical medium. It'll be a visiting medium. It goes in the background, comes in the front, goes in the background. Radio is extremely, according to me, powerful. Digital. There's going to be a lot of digital presence. I believe a lot of young people are listening to podcasts and stuff. People love it. They also, like I said, radio is not going to be a background medium. You'll see a lot of stuff happening in your city because it's such a local medium. All other mediums are either national or semi-local, but radio is a dedicated local medium, and you'll start seeing a lot of reflection of that on ground, on digital, and on air. That's the future, and podcasts, of course. Yeah, just go do it. Walk into a radio station, figure out what your preferred language is, and look for the radio stations. Basic research. Walk in, go ask the producer you'd like to audition. If they give you a slot, just audition. Think of 2-3 things you'd like to talk about. Practice at home, record it, try and keep it tight. And what people don't realize is you smile a little when you're talking because people can hear it. And that's the only thing they have. So if you smile, you can hear. If I said, you know, hi, how are you doing this evening? Or hi, how are you doing this evening? It changes your entire, just because you've opened your mouth a little, you can, you know, when you hear someone, you're like, are you smiling? Are you upset? Because, so when you're recording, you tend to get nervous, a little anxious. Just breathe, smile, and go with the flow.